At first at 6, we go one-on-one with Wright State President David Hopkins on his decision not to host a presidential debate here this fall. Our area will miss out on the national spotlight and millions of dollars, a move that many officials say they're frankly disappointed with. TUNY's reporter Maytal Levy asking questions about what went into that tough decision.
Wright State University Dr. David Hopkins, president, tells me this is the hardest decision in his career he's ever had to make. While he understands many are disappointed, he says it's something he had to do.
When did it first enter your mind that Wright State would no longer hold a debate?
I think it was about a week ago when we had a public meeting, and part of the meeting was discussing the challenges of our budget remediation plan. And as we saw the estimates on security. And
the university budgeted $8 million, but Hopkins tells me the cost would be more, millions more.
And I have made a promise from the very beginning that we would do our best to raise all the costs for this debate from external sources. And it was clear to me that I was going to be very difficult for us to accomplish that.
He tells me he's concerned about the climate of the country right now. He says the decision fell on him and it was based on the safety of the staff and students.
My priority as the president of Wright State University is the safety and the financial health of this institution. And so that has to be my priority, and I'm sorry that we could not deliver, but it was not in the cards this time.
What would your message be to students or faculty that are disappointed?
I'm personally disappointed. I know people know that because this is something we worked for a couple years to try to position Wright State and Ohio and this Dayton region to bring.
Hopkins retires in June. A successful debate would have been a part of his legacy.
Now, with this not happening, what do you feel your legacy is to the university?
Well, what I've always cared about, and I've done this for 42 years, and so for me, it's always about the students.
The university hired two external employees to plan the debate. Dr. Hopkins tells me tomorrow he'll meet with them to discuss what's next. To see that full interview in its entirety, go to WDTN.com. Maytal Levy, 2 News, working for you.